out the house now.
What's up, y'all?
All right, y'all.
Facebox animation.
My man.
At this interview for Dante's Boxing Nation, Charlo, the Jamal Charlo, is a WBC mandatory for Canelo's WBC belt. Do you think that Canelo is actually going to take that fight?
Canelo would be stupid to take that fight with Charlo right now because he got a guy that he already having two fights with that have been very, very, very close fights. Both fights could have went either way.
Okay.
Therefore, to me, not only do Canelo, but the world want to see him rectify that, just like how Marquez and Pacquiao would.
Gotcha.
We didn't want to see nobody else fight Pacquiao, but Marquez until he settled it for real. Marquez finally caught him and knocked him out. Now we cool. Now we closed that book and went on to the next one.
Okay.
Right?
Okay.
So
right.
Right now in boxing, the way boxing is going, boxing is too good right now to mess up good fights that we already know is a guaranteed good fight.
A good sale.
We already know if they fight again, that's guaranteed. A good fight.
Because that was an epic bout. There's no denying it. That was an epic bout.
You can't ask for a better fight than that. So why would we mess that up and go match one of them against somebody else right now when them two are pulling the best out of each other? Canelo pulled the best boxing out of Triple G, and Triple G pulled the best stalking out of Canelo.
That makes sense.
They pulled the best out of each other. The only problem is, like I said, I understand both sides for everybody. But my problem is, because this is how I was raised. I could be wrong, but this is how I was raised. If you challenge that man in a water fight, then y'all should be fighting in the water. If you challenge that man in a fight, then y'all should be fighting in fight. Now, if you gonna stay above that and just say, nah, we challenge you in a fight, if you bring fire, I'm gonna bring water. That's boxing. But this ain't how this happened. Y'all see it? No. We've been claiming Mexican style for 5 years. We want you in a Mexican style battle.
But even Julio Cesar Chavez Sr. had gotten on Canelo, not Canelo, but Triple G, saying, hey, you said that you claim about this Mexican style from the first time that they met. It was like, you really didn't do that. You know, are you going to engage a little bit more next time?
Sort of.
Okay.
But he didn't know enough to keep against the ropes and stay there and do that.
Okay.
And that means that you got to take some, give some. That's what Mexicans do. Julio Cesar Chavez knows that. So he wasn't willing to stay there and take some and give some, which is why a lot of observers gave Canelo, thought Canelo won the first fight, and they called it a draw. Because we thought you was a killer. You've been killing everybody else. And you've been saying Mexican style, that means you don't back up for nothing.
Okay.
But Canelo hit you a few times, you slow down some. So now that makes us one in our minds. Then Canelo slow down, then you pick it back up. So because you did that, I thought I would have gave you the first fight still because I thought you outworked Canelo. But the second fight, you said, nah, I don't want Canelo to move around in box. I want a Mexican style fight.
Right in front of
him. Challenge a Mexican to a Mexican fight. When he brought that to you, you retreated. I'm sorry, bro, but you can't do that. You just can't do that.
Not when you call him out like that.
Exactly, you can't do that. He step up and do it, and he come up and wait to fight you, and he make you change, and you tell him you want to fight Mexican style, and he make you go box? No, bro, I can't give you that. I mean,
I understand,
but I can't give you that.
Legendary.